What's happening, kids? It's your girl Kiki, aka Key Kizzle, aka Kiz Nye. Anyhow, we're sitting right here on Ventura Boulevard, and pretty much today we're doing some shopping with your girl Keeks. I wanted to show you guys kind of how I put together my outfits for the week, how I prepare, and also how I do my shopping in LA. So right now, first we're gonna be going to Iguana Vintage Clothing, which is, like I said, right on Ventura Boulevard. Just checking with the lady and son, so I'm cool when I go in there to shoot, you know what I'm saying? But anyhow, this is the first shop of a few that we're gonna be going to, so stick around for the ride. So as you guys know, Gigi Fernandez is my amazing stylist and she has been killing it. So I also always have her coming with me shopping just so we can kind of bounce ideas off of each other, think about unique things we might want to try. Hey, say hey, Gigi. Hey. She be shy. She's a Cancer. Y'all know I'm into astrology. So I love those sunglasses that I just, I just tried on some like, what's the word I'm looking for? The peace sign, like, but in sunglasses. I'll show them to y'all when I come back around. Love the store. See, this is the type of stuff that I always like because, I don't know, I feel like it's all about character and clothing, and I think that's why I love to shop in vintage, because you sometimes get pieces of other people's characters, you can change it, switch it up, but the clothing already has so much story to it. Not to say that, you know, really new clothes don't have story to them as well, but there's something about vintage clothing that makes you feel like, you know, you're a part of someone else's story and you're recreating and inspiring on top of what somebody else already inspired you to want to get.
This is where I got your jacket and all the patches.
Yes. This is a good jacket. That's another thing. You can never find, like, I love Levi's, but you find the best Levi's in vintage stores. You can find it in like places like Iguana. You can also find it in places like Urban Outfitters that sell a lot of old Levi's stuff, and it has that very unique cut that you just can't find anymore.
Sometimes it's hard to find the smallest they have.
That's probably the hardest thing about shopping in vintage stores is, depending on how they set up is, it might take you hours to find your size, to find your exact cut and style, but it also is the fun part. So bring friends with you and just have a blast. This is kind of dope to me too. I mean, it looks crazy, but it's kind of dope. With the even with that.
Oh, and that's your thing.
You know what I mean? I love the bedazzling and stuff like that. And I don't know. I'm huge on camo, y'all. Maybe I get.
Oh, this is the same one without the.
Yeah. I like that rainbow one too, though. Kind of. What would I do this with? What do you think would be cool with it? Something new we could add to it.
We could put stuff that you already have in your closet with this too, and just play around with it. Forgot what we
do. That's another thing about vintage clothing. I don't know, might just chill on it. You know what I mean? Chill on it, yeah. Another thing I like about vintage clothing is that, what's the word I was just gonna say? My train of thought got, sometimes you'll go into a vintage store and you'll see a cool piece. Like, I remember Gigi saw this really cool piece in a vintage store where it was almost like a grandma, something your grandma would have worn back in the day. It was like a bedazzled jean type of suit thing. And when you see stuff like that, you may not always know where you want to wear it to, but if you see it and it catches your eye, just buy the shit and then figure out how you're going to do the outfit with it later. You don't have to always think about going in to get an outfit. Just get all the things you like and then you can create the outfit when you get home.
I feel like you have so many jackets.
I know, I do have so many jackets, but you know what I don't have is the leather jackets. Enough of those. Yeah. Thank you. This is so dope. Again, history. It has history, character to it. It's what I like. How's it look? Gigi is so funny. She gets so dramatic when she sees me in something good, like I'm her own private doll. Yeah, this is hot. This is a cool jacket. I love this jacket.
Yeah.
Now, that's what I liked about it is because it has the box fit.
Yeah.
That's what I want. This,
you know what I mean? Jackets like that now.
Even when the arms are so big like this, I don't even mind. Because the arms are totally huge.
I like it.
But I don't mind it. It looks cute.
I love that.
I love this jacket.
Yeah, okay, so we definitely gonna get this. This is dope, ain't it?
Love you.
Hey, thank you, Mama. Love you. Mom came by, you know her.
It's an actual military one.
That's what I'm saying. Can you wear it for me? Because I can't put it on my head.
Bye. I'll see you. You guys have a good day. Those pictures came out awesome yesterday. Jason is good.
Yeah, he's really, it's a little tight on me.
Jason is good.
Yeah, but that's a cute hat. I like that hat.
I'm going to go. Guess what? We satisfied.
You don't have to go, Mom.
No, no. I got the baby in the car.
Oh, okay. Get the baby.
We
who in the car with the baby?
L'Oreal's in the car. We got Corey's Benjamin happy yesterday.
Sorry about that. See? Yeah, I like this hat. This is a dope ass hat. About to mess up my hair. I love it.
Do you think it'll fit you though?
Cause my head is little. It. Yeah, it worked with just then. It's really cool that my family lives in LA with me. I mean, I moved to California when I was a kid, and I'm really glad that even though I'm an adult, they stayed, because a lot of times I'll be working and I won't be able to have time to really, you know, go see them, so they come to me. Hey, girl! Hey, girl. Look how she looked like, was she just crying or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, she looks like she's been through it. What have you been doing to her?
Traumatic.
What have you been doing to my girl?
Nobody's doing anything to her.
She's honestly the most magnificent child. She looks like a doll, baby. This is not even realistic.
And L'Oreal was saying that put her in commercials and stuff. I said, hey, Kiki, her auntie Kiki is branding her already. Everybody know who this baby is.
This is the new, hello, Gerber. I've got a message for you. This is who you need. Alexandra, this is who you need.
Look how she looked all dramatic. The baby turned and looked all dramatic.
Look at her. She's honestly the best thing since sliced bread. Love you. Where's AJ at?
All right, y'all have a great day.
Locked him in? Look how she looking. Bye, y'all.
Bye-bye.
Handled a little business real quick with Moms. Now I'm getting back to shopping. I like something like this.
That's cute.
Let me look at it all.
A little 70s.
You know what I'm saying?
Let me
skip this one. Yeah. Yeah. This is cold. This reminds me of Lil' Kim.
Yeah.
This is cute.
Yeah.
For sure. I like the shape of these, but what color would be nice?
Oh, I like these too. Let me see, are they too worn in the crotch in the back though? Oh, they look a little too worn.
It's disgusting. That was literally, that's another thing about shopping vintage. Watch the fuck out. Cause some of the shit,
oh my God.
Like, homie, you couldn't make it to the bathroom? So scary and nerve-wracking when you find shoes that you like in a vintage store, because if you're a big foot like me, 9 times out of 10, you might not have your size. I like shoes like this. Very Slutty Baby style. Isn't that the style of you would say? That's the aesthetic. Slutty Baby vibes.
What I have, because I send those to the other store. The
you get, yeah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Love it. Love it. Adorable. Adorable. Completely.
Very cute.
Completely adorable.
They are cute. Oh, it was these.
Uh-oh, your girl has lucked out.
What size? She's a 9, 9 and a half. It doesn't come half size.
Oh.
9 and a 10. If you have both, yeah, okay.
With the new leather jacket I bought. Changed the outfit up just that quick. I went from street to suite that fast. Isn't that crazy how one little thing can just change outfit?
I love that.
Oh, honey, I love this. I might be walking out with these on. These shoes are so damn cute.
Yeah, the mule.
Is that what it's called?
Mule, yeah. When there's no back?
No. What I mean is the fact that it's huge at the top.
The big platform, yeah.
These, do they fit?
Yeah, I'm gonna just take these things out real quick though. It's a little hanging out the back.
So maybe 8.5?
No, it's hanging out, meaning it's too small.
Oh,
so then small? What size were the ones she tried on?
The pink ones?
This is the 9.
So maybe a 10.
The 10?
Yes.
Because
they fit differently.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Uh-huh. Yes. Oh!
Those are so cute.
These are so cute.
And you can do so much with them.
So much. Oh my goodness. And then it's just like, it looks like show-stopping shoes. Mm-hmm. If you're walking around in these shoes, everybody's watching. Mm-hmm. I love them. Love them. And it's just very like easy breezy. Mm-hmm. No strap, no da da da, no nothing. Yeah, I love these. I appreciate it. You will see me.
You will, yes.
Thank you again for letting me show. Thank you. Bye. Alrighty, so we're done with Iguana. Now we're getting ready to head over to, I think Gigi wants to go to Wilshire, so we'll hit up some of the department stores before we hit another, like, you know, kind of store like this. So let's go for the ride. Okay, as you guys can see, we have changed up the scenery right now. We're in Saks, so now I'm doing a little bit of my department store shopping. And as y'all know, it has everything from the Christian Louboutin to the Gucci to the Louis Vuitton to the whatever. You know what I mean? It has everything. So I'm just looking around, seeing what I want. I don't really know what I want. I didn't necessarily come in here looking for anything specific, but if I see some shoes, apparel, we just go for it. In stores like this, I don't really go for the trendy things because it's so overpriced. No offense to some of the designers. Y'all know y'all overpriced. But it's so overpriced that I don't want to get something that's only going to be all right for the season if I can't really repeat it. Unless it's something that, of course, I'm just dying for. But nine times out of 10, I try to be really smart about it because you don't want to just buy stuff just because it's really popping right now and it be away. So got to be careful in these kind of stores. These are the ones I really want for sure. These are the ones I really want. I already knew from the jump. So I'm definitely going to ask, who do we ask? They got a DJ up in here. What's up with them? I'm saying, how cute are these? But they're so trendy. You know, to be honest.
6 months later,
you're right, exactly. And my thing is, you might could find something really cute similar to this. What do you think? Forever 21 sometimes. Forever 21, you can get Zara. You can get you a really cute one that's not going up. I mean, because even, I'm not. Somebody might say, oh, you should buy that. I would not spend this. No. Unless it makes perfect sense to me.
You.
These are so me. I'll put this on with a bag.
Yeah. These
are for you. Oh my gosh. We can keep it on the DL. Hell nah, girl, I'll never tell you what a new nigga. I love makeup so much, y'all. I literally walked in here. Once we walked through the bridge between the clothing and the makeup, I literally walked in like I was a dude in the club, like this. Because I'm ready. For the makeup. I used to do crazy shoe shopping when I was a teenager. I was it was right around when I was working on True Jackson VP, and I used to be excessive about it, like to the point where my parents like had to talk to me one time, like not excessive, like crazy, because you know my parents don't play. But I remember they had to have a talk about it with me. And literally, like, I feel so mad because I look back on a lot of stuff that I bought and I wish that I was a smarter buyer because I bought so many, you know, expensive shoes that were very trendy for that time. And so to the point where I can't even really wear them now because they're not that in. So I really had, I learned a lesson with that. Like, sometimes it's not so much about quantity as much as it's about quality.
Yeah, she does a lot of, a little bit of her fans and stuff.
This is a 9.
Thank you. These are tight.
These are tight. Would you wear that sock with it?
Nah.
No.
Oh, do you have the thin ones?
Yeah, yeah. Let me grab
you
that.
But do you still feel that they're too tight?
Yeah, they're a little too tight still.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? It might be right. You might be right. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna cry. Yeah, this is it. This is it. Wait, your face, yo. Gigi look like, yeah, I said, I do. She said, is it? Yes, perfect. I'm Cinderella.
There you go. It was meant to be.
It was meant to be. Oh my gosh, I love this damn shoe.
Denim, just denim on a white top. It's really easy to wear.
It's easy to wear. I love the shoe. Great buy.
Okay.
What's done is done.
So we don't have to worry about overnighting or anything.
Thanks. Oh, I'm about to put my shoes on when I'm outside. Sounds wonderful. Thank you. I'm very happy about this all. Why does it no picket fence? Baby, you know we don't want the same thing. Why you caught up in your feelings? I felt the same as I did yesterday. Baby, we've been through this and I feel the same way. No, you don't wanna hear this and I hate to say, babe. Alrighty, so we just pulled up to Riff LA off La Brea. And I love Riff mainly because I can get a lot of the most, it's like a smorgasbord of all the most classic street brands, my favorite being Supreme. I remember I got this really dope cashmere Supreme sweater, but it didn't say Supreme anywhere. It was just like a cashmere sweater, but the cut of it was so dope. And you know, it's probably not many of them there. Like, so I always can find really cool pieces here, especially shoes, sneakers. I'm a big sneaker head, so it'll be some good stuff. Different from Iguana, but dope. Okay, so Riff LA is kind of like two stores. Like, they have one where it's mostly apparel, then they have the other one that's mostly sneakers. And it's really a consignment store, meaning people sell limited things that weren't out a couple of years ago that maybe they don't want anymore or need anymore, and they bring them here and they resell them. But you find the coolest stuff because, like I said, it's limited things, so you're never gonna be able to find it again, another piece of it. And this is the store to get it from. So this section right here is full of Bape stuff. And as y'all can see, everybody's been rocking hella Bape lately. So like, if I was gonna get a Bape t-shirt at this point, it'll probably be like something like this, keeping it more clean and classic and not the usual crazy patterns of Bape, since it's been so much of it. I usually try to like dial it back or switch it up instead of doing the same exact thing. You can never go wrong with Supreme, because the way that they've done their brand is that everything is, like I said, only one time. So you always feel like you're getting something fresh and new with Supreme, because that's how they do it. They make sure the product is just on point, and they also make you feel like you're getting something exclusive. Without my ponytail,
it'll be
so cute. It's great, right? It's totally great. Oops. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It's just too adorable.
And it's a small, it's almost like a meant to be. That's cute as hell.
So cute.
That's so cute.
So cute. Good pick.
Yes.
Good pick. We got some good buys. So this is the sneaker side. And like I was saying, it's a consignment store. So all these shoes, you know, have been reupholstered, I guess I can say. So I'm gonna just look around and see if they have anything that I want to get. It's just so cutesy because it's like
colored
all this stuff on it. I thought it was real interesting. You gotta have stuff that you could be stylish in when you're resting. So I may not ever wear these, let's say, to the club, but I wear them to the gym. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? I wear these to the gym and they still fly.
Yeah. Exactly.
So I'm about to get these for Frank, my brother-in-law. He's been hanging around all day, like helping me with my Snapchat and stuff. So. He said he liked these shoes, so hopefully he wasn't just talking. That moment you realize you can't get the shoes you wanted because you got a big ass foot, and the only size they got is a woman's 8, and I'm a woman's 10, sometimes a 9.5. All right, I hope y'all have fun shopping with your girl. Make sure you stay tuned on all things Kiki at, of course, KikiPalmer.com and my Instagram and all my other socials. How the way I simply look. Okay.